Delhi's air quality has been in the red or very poor category. When is that going to change? Well, a group of six friends have decided to come up with a low-cost sensor to tell you what the air pollution is like within the four walls of your home. In fact, one of them says he's even considering leaving the city because his children can't see the sky, can't see the stars from Delhi every night.
We live on the Ring Road and we have the metro construction going right in front of us. So it's a constant problem for us. We can't open our windows. At least 10-15 days before Diwali, when we stand in the balcony and we stay on the 7th floor, there is nothing that can be, you know, seen outside. There's so much dust and so much pollution.
If you're wondering how much pollution we breathe in every single day, there's an answer to that question. And what's more, 39-year-old Mrityunjay Mishra and his five co-founders are making that answer accessible to all. Founded in March last year, their startup, Indian Open Data Association, assembles low-cost air quality monitoring systems of three different variants that record various parameters from dust particles to noise pollution levels and reveal the real-time quality of our air. This cause was a very personal one for Mrityunjay, since he even considered moving out of Delhi due to rising air pollution.
My dad was saying, son, it's time for you to leave this city. You came here in 98, now time, just move. I said, why? He said, look at the sky, you can't see the stars. I said, I have like Google Sky Map in my mobile phone. That's what I used to show stars to my kids.
In March 2015, Mrityunjay traveled to Nasik for the Kumbathon, a forum where various innovators come together to test potential tech solutions. And there, he assembled close to 50 sensors with the help of technology experts.
Where is the public participation in all of this? That's our more interest. Okay, our real interest is, can open data transform into knowledge and then to action? And action by people.
Since the Central Pollution Control Board also measures air quality data, let's do a quick comparison. The board has 53 sensors installed across the country, while this startup has 40. The board sensors collect real-time data at 60-minute intervals, while the startup sensors collect the same at 5-minute intervals. Data from these low-cost sensors are accessed by NGOs such as Greenpeace, entrepreneurs, professors, and various individuals interested in solving our severe air pollution problems. Since Dasera, the air in Delhi has been marked red, which means very poor. Now the question is, can civic bodies and private stakeholders use data from such technology to come up with efficient solutions for our air pollution problems? In New Delhi with camera person Sumi and Anoop, Real Media for NDTV.
And we'll in fact